Hi Founder fans, Jason here, and today's founder is John Parke Custis, stepson of George Washington. Now John Parke Custis's father, Daniel Parke Custis, passed away when John was just 3 years old, leaving his mother Martha a widow. Famously, about 2 years later, Martha would marry George Washington, as I alluded to earlier, and John Parke just Custis, or Jackie as he was known, would grow up at Mount Vernon. And for the most part, George Washington would raise John Parke Custis as his own son. That being said, John Parke Custis did inherit a large amount of tracts of land and human beings that were enslaved. Of course, both the property and the people were under the care of George Washington until John came of age. That being said, seems like John Parke Custis grew up as kind of a spoiled rich kid. He disappointed his parents on many occasions, was known to be lazy, just kind of spent money flippantly, with not much a care in the world. Being said, by the time he turns 18, Custis has already gone to King's College in New York, what we know today as Columbia, but left early, came back home after a sibling passed away, and he starts getting married. Yeah, he kind of gets married real quick, which both his mother and stepfather very much disapprove of. He was just a young man with a bright future. What are you doing? So, John ends up with his new bride buying a place called White House. Now, it's not the White House we know today. It was just a property called that. But 2 years later, he ends up buying another property called Abingdon. Now, Abingdon was a lot cheaper than he paid for it. By which I mean, John Parke Custis well overpaid on the property and took out incredibly high interest rates. When George Washington found out about this, he again reprimanded the young man for being so oblivious to what things should actually cost and really wasting a ton of money. Now, George Washington, shortly thereafter, was at the Second Continental Congress, and he was appointed as commander-in-chief of some new army they were starting. He actually writes home to John Parke Custis a really nice letter explaining, you know, that Washington's personal feelings on being given this weighty position, and expresses certain emotional feelings towards John Parke Custis as well. Washington did view Johnny, or Jackie as he was called, as his own son. And you can see this in some of the letters they write to each other. Now, John Parke Custis, along with his mother, actually joined George Washington in Boston not long after, and John acts as kind of an unofficial aide-de-camp to George Washington. Custis would soon leave, go back home to take care of his property and his personal affairs, but he's then, in 1778, John is elected to the Virginia House of Representatives, where he spends a year hobnobbing with some of the other really important American founders. That being said, turns out young John was really good at speaking out of turn, and in fact, General George Washington takes time to write from commanding the Continental Army to John Parke Custis to say, hey, you gotta know your position. You just got there. There was, and this is true, there was a very specific order to who got to speak first and such. The person there longest, with the most seniority, the most elite level in this aristocratic style society they had, were the most important. John Parke Custis was very far down the list, and as I said, Washington stopped running the army for a few minutes to write a letter, again, reprimanding his stepson for misbehaving. Now, close to the end of the war, John actually volunteers for the Continental Army. He ends up serving with George Washington when Washington comes down to Virginia and is actually again acting as a volunteer aide-de-camp to George Washington during the victory at Yorktown. And this really is John's crowning achievement as an American founder. He very well could have gone on to many more great things, but unfortunately, while he's at camp, he catches what's called cabin fever, which was probably dysentery, but it could have been one of several diseases. Camp fever. Unfortunately, less than 2 weeks after the British surrender at Yorktown, John Parke Custis dies at just 26 years old. Unfortunately, this should have been a time of celebration in the Washington household, but between George Washington and Martha Washington, they had just lost one of their children, and it put a real damper on what should have been the most momentous occasion in General George Washington's, at least his military career, if not his entire life. Interestingly about John Parke Custis, although just 26 years old, he had several children, six children actually, four of whom would live to adulthood, one, George Washington Custis, would have a daughter that would go on to marry Robert E. Lee of Civil War fame. So there's that fun tie-in there. Again, George Washington didn't have any children of his own, and while he had many adopted sons, as they're known, young men who served with him in the Continental Army, and many of whom would later serve in the federal government, John Parke Custis really was his actual adopted son. So now you know a little bit more about George Washington's personal family life, the story of John Parke Custis. If you enjoyed this video, do me a favor and hit like so more people can learn about the American Revolution along with us. And if you're new here, subscribe. I put out videos about the American Revolution 7 days a week. I'll be back with another founder for you tomorrow.